Hello everyone, and welcome to this anniversary video for the channel. It's been 4 years since I started this YouTube channel. It's been a while. A lot's happened. Mainly, one thing I would like to say is that we've gotten several new subscribers to the channel, which is awesome. And I just want to say thank you guys for hanging out, because that's awesome. And I certainly hope you guys have been enjoying what's been coming out. And that's a couple things I wanted to touch up on this video. I kind of mentioned it in the upcoming videos of Sacred Stones, and I don't get into too much detail about it, but I'm hoping that I can enlighten you with this video. This should be the 27th when this video comes out. If not, I am behind. I'm just behind. Just put it that way. So, one of the things that I want to touch on besides let's just go ahead and kind of start off with the subscribers. Thank you. I am genuinely thanking you. That is awesome. And I certainly hope you guys are enjoying yourselves and watching the content I've got. As far as, I don't know what else to say other than thank you. The next thing I want to touch up on is the, what is it called? I had it at the tip of my tongue. Okay. I'll go ahead and kind of mention what I was talking about in the Sacred Stones. I started mentioning it in chapter 20 because I had 19 already recorded before this was mentioned, and I kind of talk about it in 20, and also in the bonus episode I get a little bit more detail about it. But I got a suggestion to do a let's play of just do videos on Pokemon Go. I feel bad that I can't do it. I'll just be honest. I'll be straight up honest. But one of the things is, I don't have any way to record it. I don't have camera or camcorder or something I can hook my phone up to record it. I don't have any of that. I'm barely making it by with the recording equipment I've got, so there's that. I'm not barely making it by. I've finally got a somewhat steady job that I've been able to get some stuff for this channel. One of the videos. No, I'm thinking ahead. Good grief. I feel terrible. I'm sorry. And that's basically what I mentioned. If I could record it, maybe, but I don't have a way. Which, I thought, well, I feel bad. Someone mentioned a video I could try to do something of. What could I do? So, after giving it some thought, I was like, hey, I could totally do this. And it's like, oh, this year's 20th anniversary for Pokemon and all that. So one of the things I was like, okay, I kind of want to do this is, well, actually no, it's the, yeah, it is the 20th. Gosh, I feel terrible. Sometimes I can't remember it. I think partially because in the United States we didn't get Pokemon until 1998, and the game actually came out in 96 in Japan, so yeah, it's 20 years. I've already done a Pokemon Let's Play, but that was of Ruby, one of my more favorite Game Boy titles before it went to like dual screen and all that. That was, I would say, one of my, I would say my favorite out of just the one screen type of GBA Pokemon titles. But I was alive when the first Pokemon game came out, and Pokemon Red and Pokemon Blue. I would play Pokemon Blue when it came out back in 98. Great, that is so long ago, I feel like an old person. But I do want to do a Let's Play of Leaf Green, which is the remake of it. And reason why I'm not doing the original, because I thought about doing the original, but since, as like a, hey, it's the 20th anniversary of Pokemon, we'll re-release the Red, Blue, and Yellow on the Nintendo eShop, you can buy them and have fun. And I did, because I was one of those kids that got sucked into like selling old games to get new ones, and Blue was one of them I sold. One of the many regrets of my life, that was actually one of them, where I went and sold a whole bunch of games to get a new one, and I was so naive. I sold so many games I love and I miss to this day, so sad. But thankfully there's other ways to get them now. And I was playing through Blue. I noticed these Pokemon, their movesets, they suck. I'm not even joking. The beginner I picked, just kind of for all nostalgia's sake, because the first beginner I picked was Bulbasaur. I picked Bulbasaur, and I played through it. Venusaur was trying to learn Sleep Powder, or something like that, at like level 50, or at like 50, 52. I was like, what? You should be learning Solar Beam, not this Sleep Powder nonsense. The most powerful move you got with you is freaking Mega Drain, or Body Slam. What the heck is this with you trying to learn Sleep Powder? But yeah, that's the old Pokemon. Where learning moves was just the most bizarre thing ever. Especially since the TMs you got were kind of bizarre as well. And the glitches you could do. Oh gosh. Oh man. But that aside, and honestly, if I did play through Blue, I would be so tempted to do all the glitches to make the game so easy. I mean, honestly, it would take me less than probably 2 or 3 days to play through the whole game if I actually put my mind to it. Because it's by far no big game, but there are gripes I have with it, and they're there, and it's insane. And I don't, gosh, I'll get into it when I go through the game. So there is that. And I should be able to, I will go ahead and tell you this, guys. I should be able to do more videos than just one a week. I should. Doesn't mean I'll be able to pull it off. But considering I'm not having to replay the same chapter 6 or 7 times for Fire Emblem, I'm just playing through a video game like any nerd would, just having some fun, I should be able to kind of go through it without too much of a problem. So there is that. The editing, I am going to be doing some unique editing that I haven't done with, I didn't do with Ruby. I don't think I did any editing with Ruby, to be honest. Oh, gosh. Yeah, I don't think I did. I don't think I even put end slates at the end of the thing back then. Yeah, I don't think I did. Oh, boy. That's when I was in such a odd place back then. A lot of personal stuff going back then, and some really weird personal stuff going on this past year, and some depressing ones. I won't put you guys in that awkward position of knowing it, so there's that. I do want to thank you guys for your patience if you stuck around, especially when there sometimes was just no video, or I put out a video like Monday of 1 week and the next week I didn't put it out till like Saturday. There was no rhythm to when I could get a video out, and I apologize. I am going to honestly apologize, but sometimes editing problems show up, and good grief, this past like month has been nothing but editing problems, and trying to get them fixed is a pain in the butt. And when I got one of and I think I know what the problem may be, and hopefully this problem is fixed. I'm hoping that. But all in all, I think I should be able to have the problem fixed and I won't have any more problems. But to kind of put it in perspective, like, I would start Adobe Premiere up, and when I go to kind of finagle with the video, it would just go cockeyed and just have a freak out to the point where it froze and the program just died. I've tried restarting my computer and everything, and I found temporary solutions by actually like deleting all the video files that were it, like all the gameplay on there, and just edited what else needed to be there, and then put the video in, and just kind of hope and prayed that I could actually get the video to work. Man, that's how the last two came out. That's how like chapter 17 and 18 came about. Me just hoping and praying everything worked. So hopefully 19 should be out the day this video goes out, that or the next day, depending on how my editing goes. I really don't know how it'll go, to be honest. If it goes well, it should be out same day this comes out. If not, it will come out on Thursday. So hopefully you guys are okay with that. And if I get it all squared off, I should have all the videos edited by the end of the week, and I'll just put them out next week. Have, like, one out Monday, then Wednesday, then Friday, but don't hold me to that. Please don't. Because I have no idea what's going to happen. I don't think anyone knows what's going to happen in the future of events and all that jazz. But anyway, so there is that, the idea of doing Pokemon, and while it is going to be a pretty edited series, kind of like, and I was kind of messing around on how to do layouts. I've been doing that for a while, but I did that with Golden Sun. I did that a little bit, I started out with the other Fire Emblem when I started doing Hector's story, but I got more into it when I was doing Golden Sun, and I tried to do a much... the editing I tried to do for this series, I wanted to be very informative and be as helpful as possible. And hopefully I have been. So, there's that. But I am going to be taking a break from Fire Emblem games just so I can actually start to enjoy them again. Because I don't know what's going on, but usually I don't have as much of a problem playing through Fire Emblem Sacred Stones as I've had this time around, despite me going through it the way I have. Oh my gosh. You'll see it at the end credits of how, well, maybe you won't. I don't know. You'll get some indication of how many times I've had to restart the game. There might be some that it may not be. It's not. I don't think it will be 100% accurate, but it'll be close enough. But yeah, that has been one series. I don't know. I think what I'm gonna do. I'm just going to be honest. If I do another Fire Emblem game, I am not doing hard. I'm going to do it to be very leisure about it. Sure, I love challenges, but for some reason, whenever I try to do one of these games on hard while I record, everything wants to go wrong. So, I think I'm going to take that into account when I do the next one, which I don't know when that would be. So, if you're here just for that, I'm sorry. I don't know when I'm going to do another one. I need to not be burned out by these games. And I got to the point where I just... Because, like, I know I've mentioned several times I've been playing Fire Emblem Fates on my own free time. I have seriously stopped playing it. And I'm playing, like, Monster Hunter 4 for all my 3DS. Just to get away from it. Because as much as I enjoy it, I got to the point where I got so frustrated, I would make the dumbest mistakes. So. And I'm actually getting into playing Monster Hunter again. It's actually quite fun. Funny, because this monster, I think it's Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate, is actually the first one I got. And that's an interesting story of why I ended up getting it anyway. I don't know. I can't exactly... I know I was getting Fire... What am I talking about? Fire Emblem. The remake... Majora's Mask 3D remake. And... I was gonna get another game. I can't remember what it was for the life of me. But they didn't have it. I was like, ah, man. And the guy was like, well, is there any other game you might want to try? I don't know what... Because I had played the demo, and I didn't really like it. I didn't really like Monster Hunter. But I was like, I guess I'll get Monster Hunter. I don't know what possessed me to say that, but I did. And, oh boy, was I in for a surprise. I actually really like it. It's so much fun. And some of it's frustrating trying to get some of the stuff done, but a lot of it's pretty fun. What else? For those who have come in like this year, well, I don't know if I need to talk, I don't know, I talked about Pokemon, I talked about, like, the plan for that, I talked about new people coming, and I was really happy about it and all that. I thought I was missing something. Here's something else. Kind of depends on how all this thing goes with Pokemon. I don't know if I want to do this, but you guys let me know what you guys want. to go, how you guys want to go about it. I keep saying a lot. If you didn't know, I do that a lot. Especially when I'm trying to get the words kind of construed out. And it's really hard to do that if I don't actually have it all written out. And honestly, I don't like doing that, so... Welcome to my world where I just do all the time. Gosh. Even when I have to cough, I do it. Okay, so... This is to more or less bring variety to the channel, which kind of ties into what I want to talk about with this. About the whole capture card thing. The way it's going to go is I'm going to have to send my old capture card back to the company I bought it from. And after talking, this has happened over like a month of me trying to talk to them and get this whole problem fixed so I don't have to worry about it. Turns out this is it's a possible problem that's with the hardware or there's something on their end. And it's not my problem, thank goodness, which is a good thing, because I thought it might have been me. But the thing is apparently a known problem, and I don't know if what they've done to try to fix it, but it sucks that I'm kind of stuck with the product that's kind of faulty. So there you go. Because what would happen is I would plug it up to my console. And some of the problems have been fixed, but not all of them. The first problem I had when I got it was it would play the audio on my TV, but it wouldn't show the video on my TV. I'm like, that's bizarre. But the more frustrating thing was when I started the capture software, my computer crashed every single time. So there you go. Yeah, and the thing is, it's not the program, because I can start the program and the console be off, it's fine. But as soon as I start the console up that's hooked up to the capture card, immediately dies. So that's a thing, and after talking to them for about a month, they're like, hey, you might want to send that back to us. And I just haven't had the time to go by the post office to mail it, so... Hopefully I'll be able to mail that off and get everything good to go. And once they get the capture card, they'll send me another one, one of the models that actually should work. So I'll be able to do Wii U and PS4 game capture, which is going to be awesome. Because I've been wanting to do that, and I haven't been able to, which is sad. Because, especially with a game that came out last month by the name of Star Ocean Integrity and Faithlessness, I've been wanting to play that for you guys blind, but I couldn't, and I was just like, I want to play this game. I just more or less said, you know what, I don't know when or if this problem's going to get fixed, so I am going to play. And I'll be honest, it's a very fun game. Short compared to the other Star Ocean games. It's way shorter in terms of the main story. I don't know how much after game content there is. I'm still playing through that. Here and there. And I'm actually playing through another game I had gotten for my PS4 when I actually got the PS4. I had gotten two games. I played through one of them. And then Star Ocean came out, and then I'm like, you know what, I kind of want to play this game, so I'm playing through Uncharted 4, actually. So far, that's actually fun. I've had some funny moments, and I wish I could share that, but whatever. I don't know if I'd be able to do that. Oh well. But that happened, and There's some interesting games I've got on my Wii U that I want to show. Finna LP or something like that. Man. Yeah, another game I'm playing through on my own time besides Uncharted 4 and when I'm out and about, Monster Hunter. I'm playing through Earthbound for the first time. Oh gosh, is that game trippy as balls. It's fun, but sometimes this just goes down the lane of crazy. And I thought some of the things I played was bizarre, but it does not match up to this game. It's fun, though. It's so much fun. But I've also had some frustrating moments while playing it. Gosh, some of it's like, where do I go? Oh my gosh. But, so, I have seriously had to have a guide up sometimes to tell me, hey, this is what you're supposed to do, because honestly, I didn't know. But that's been fun. I think I'm about halfway through the game. But there is another game that I have yet to play that I've heard is pretty good, so it's an older game as well. So that's a thing. What else? But yeah, oh yeah, more about the capture card. When they get it, they should send me one within a week. So, I would say about either probably mid-August I should have something back, and hopefully I'll have something up and running. I'll do a video if it works. If not, I'll not worry about it, but I'm hoping I'll have a more positive answer to the end of it. So, there is that. Is there anything else? Maybe sort of, possibly not. No, I don't think so. Oh, here's something I'll kind of say this and I'll sign off. It more goes to the person to, like, who asked if I could do Pokemon Go videos. If there is a game you want to suggest, feel free to just suggest it. Like I told her, I don't have a... I guess it's a her by the username. Like I told the person, I'm not capable of doing it. I don't have any way to record it. So, and who wants to see my face? It's not all that great to look at, so there you go. That's not something anyone probably wants to see. If you've got an idea for a video series or anything like that, mention it. Honestly. I'm doing this to entertain you guys, but it's also kind of like a outlet for me. Like, I get to show you guys games I've played in my life that you may have never known about, or you guys may get to point something out to me that I could do for an LP, and it's like, I don't think I've ever played that game before, and I play it, and it's like, oh, that's great, or it's like, oh, that's not so great, because I've got my own taste, you've got your taste. Hey, we've all got our own taste in video games. Some people like horror, some people like RPGs, some people like MMOs. I'm not big into the MMO thing. Honestly, I'm not. I like, if I try to get started in one, I'll play it for, like, a day, and that's it. true with pretty much every single MMO. There's one that I started, but it's a subscription thing, so it's not... And it's not WoW, for those who are wondering. I just didn't continue it because I didn't have a way to keep keep paying for it. Because I was kind of sort of jobless at the time. So there is that. If I knew, once I get more grounded into what I can, like, do in life, basically, because right now it's all over the place, I'll have more of an idea if I can actually get back into it or not at the current time. But anyway, there's that. If you do have, like, any games, like, you want to see, even if it'll be, like, a one-off video, I'll possibly create a series around viewer-suggested video games. Who knows? Oh, gosh, the possibilities for what this could become is... It could become a lot of things. And I hope it'll become something you guys will be able to stick around and say, hey, I actually like this guy on YouTube. Gosh. Anyway, I have probably bitten your ear off for far too long. And I hope to see you guys stick around for this year of cross gaming. And I certainly hope you guys will enjoy what I've hopefully got in store for you guys. I know it's like, oh, I'm hoping all this. Hoping that all this will work out, and I'm certainly hoping that you guys will enjoy this. I certainly am. And I'll see you guys in any future video that I create. Whether you use Fire Emblem or Pokemon or whatever you decide to chime back into videos of mine. I don't even know. You know what? I'm going to stop now before I get myself in trouble. Later.